time to bring this bad boy to life. Let's jump in, attach the input search, the two drop downs, and set up the workflow for the search button. And then we'll also set up the constraints to make sure that those are all hooked up and working as a set. So we've got our search button. Let's double click the button and bring up a property editor and then add a workflow. Step one, and it's the only step, we're going to go to page because we want to add some URL parameters. We've covered this in a previous section. So going to the same page, of course, because we just want to access this area down here. Check to send more parameters to the page. The text parameter will be query. Could also be search, doesn't matter. And let's just associate it with the input search. Input searches value. Next is term. All right, now we're looking for the dropdown. Dropdown terms value. And the last one, display, sorry. Dropdown terms values display. Final one is location. Dropdown locations values display. Okay, so that's the first thing we need to do. Now we have to instruct our repeating group to return the results based on this search. So I've clicked on the group card for the current cell's job. I'm going to right click and choose select first parent to get to the repeating group. You can also get there multiple other ways of which you know by now. Let's choose search for jobs. Let's add on in our parameters. So job needs to be live. Yes. So we're going to click to add a constraint. Now I'm going to choose any field. And then Bubble says any field contains. So because I want to be able to search in both the title and the description, Bubble will allow me to do that with this any field contains. I can search across multiple inputs where there is relevant text inside. Now, where is this? Well, it is in the input search, but don't forget we're using parameters for this particular user interaction. Okay, so it is the parameter is called query. We set that up previously. So I'm going to type the word get to get data from page URL. The parameter name is query, case sensitive. And the type is text. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, we have the term. Then is equal to get data from page URL, get term. And this would work if we just leave it as text, because the output of an option set option does default to text by default. But you could also choose term here if you want. Search for jobs. Now we need the location. And something we actually forgot to do earlier was we copied and pasted this drop-down term. So I'm just going to change this placeholder so it says select term. So we know that's term. And then this one on the right-hand side, I want you to change the dynamic choices because it'll be currently set to term, change to location. And then instead of all term, changes to all location. And then the rest should default to what it should. Now I'm going to type select location. Okay, but back on the repeating group, I'm using my elements tree to get back there. Now I can choose location equals get data from page URL. The parameter name is location. And like I said previously, with an option set, it defaults to text. And I can choose, look, leave it as text, or I can just choose location as well. Bubble knows what we're trying to do here. Okay, so we have these four: live, any field contains, term, location. We will continue to sort by created dates. But let's also check the box to ignore empty constraints. Otherwise, it's not going to return results if a constraint is empty. Meaning that if I just want to search a query term, but I don't want to use the dropdowns, then I can, but only if ignore empty constraints is checked. Okay, ignore empty constraints. Okay, let's try this. And I've also removed the debugger bar. I can see a small design issue here. We can go fix that soon. But for now, let's try search something like brand. I'm going to click on search, and I can see query equals brand, and here is the result. If I then say term, which is currently part-time, if I set it to full-time, click on search again, no results. Okay, and we also need a way to clear these options with a button. If we go back to part-time, yes, I can see more results. Okay, let's continue on the UI design. So I'm going to add another button here to the right-hand side. I'm going to say Command C, Command V to drop a button to the right-hand side. This button will say Reset. I'm going to change this to a secondary button. And on the workflow, which I'm going to add now, I'm simply going to say navigate to, go to page. We'll go back to the same page. And I'm going to leave everything else unchecked, just so it defaults to its original state, which is no parameters. Okay, not done yet. Back on the design tab, I don't want this reset button showing if we haven't filtered or searched. That's just poor user experience. So on the layout tab, I'm going to uncheck fix width, and I'm going to say collapse when hidden. Then on the conditional tab, I'm basically going to say that if the input search or the dropdowns, if any of them have data, that's when I want to show it, the button. So I'm going to say if input search value is not empty. Okay, now Bubble is saying, do you want to add some more expressions here? Yes, please. I'm going to say or. Drop-down terms value is not empty, or again, drop-down locations value is not empty. If any of those things equals true, so there is a value in one of those, then this element is visible. Okay, and I'm just going to group these in a new group, right-click, group elements in a row container. Let's call this group buttons. On the layout tab, I'm going to add some gap spacing just of 8 here and 8 on top as well. And now we can just remove them in height. And why is this button? I'm going to fit width to content, pardon me. Okay, so we can search, we'll keep the search button live so that a person can search and then select a term, search again, and then select the location. But as soon as there is a value in either of these three, then the reset button will appear, and that's when we actually reset everything, okay? But what I also want to do is make sure that on the edit workflow, we're also resetting data of group inputs. So anything inside that group, any input or dropdown will be reset. Let's have another go. I'm just going to clean up the URL. Can you type developer? And then search. And you can already see that there's a reset button is showing, so we could reset at that stage, which is great. I'm just going to select all three. I don't think we'll be returned. Actually, let's do the bubble one. So developer, part-time San Francisco, that will return the bubble result. Oh, and another one. Aha, see, senior developer, part-time San Francisco. Two results. We also need to sort this part out. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and reset, and everything is reset as it should. Let's just fix a few problems here before the break. So first of all, I'm going to push down on the layout tab. I'm going to choose 82 pixels of margin to get that a bit down. I'm also going to make sure that this is in front. So I'm going to say bring to front. Okay, that solves that. And then let's hook up this dynamic data here. This just needs to point to the repeating group. So take the 12 and then insert dynamic data. Type repeating group jobs, list of jobs, count. Okay, and to clean up the editor view, I'm just going to type in 12 jobs, 12 results, excuse me. Now I realize that we added a button here. I'd rather want to add a link. So I'm going to go find myself a link element, drop that inside. I'm going to change the style quickly just to a secondary button link. And now I can type apply, with meaning that we can actually use this to take a user to a job page, which we'll start designing in the next lesson. On the layout tab, I want it edge to edge by removing the fixed width, remove the min width and set the height to 44. And now we can delete the button beneath it. Excellent. One last look. Refresh the page, remove the debugger bar. Still have this issue, even though, I'll fix this up on the break. But I'm really happy with the rest of this. The functionality to be able to bookmark will come a little bit later in the next section when we sign up candidates. We can see that the date is working, posted March 25th, and then down here, posted March 18th. And in actual fact, realistically, we would have a different field to track when a job is posted, because you might create a job that might go through various forms of validation from within your company, people wanting to check that it's correct, and then it might be posted or scheduled to be posted at a later date. And by the way, that is functionality that we can employ in Bubble. The ability to schedule something dated to change at a later date, okay? But for now, I'm pretty happy with this. Select term, select location, looking really, really good. Okay, so I guess you could call that, say, part one of the section. When we get back, we're going to start designing the job display page, where someone is taken to when a job is clicked on to look at more information about the job and to be able to apply for a job. I'll see you in the next lesson.